We'll start with a case-based approach. A female patient, aged 52 years, known case of carcinoma esophagus, stage 2, and operated for esophagectomy with gastric pull-through before 1 year. Found to have right paradrachial moderately PET avid lymph node, but patient is asymptomatic. Now this is her CT PET image. You can see that hot spot in the PET scan. Now what could be the most likely diagnosis? Your options are malignancy, reactive lymph node, tuberculosis, or all of the above could be true. Your time starts now. So, D is the correct answer, but in this case, the first possibility is malignancy, and in our country we cannot rule out tuberculosis, but despite of that, we will see in the next few slides, there are trials which showed that post-malignancy, post-surgery or post-chemoradiation therapy, there are many reactive lymph nodes also. So answer is all of the above, could be true, is the correct answer. Now what will you do in this patient? Observation, thoracoscopic biopsy, mediastinoscopic biopsy, or EBUS guided biopsy? Your time starts now. So, it is obvious, it is a lecture on EBUS, so the answer is going to be EBUS guided biopsy. So previously what people used to do, either they had to go for thoracoscopic biopsy, which is very invasive tool, it is like a surgery only. Mediastinoscopic biopsy is also a surgery. Observation is not advisable in these patients, but previously people used to observe. And another thing people were doing, starting empirically chemotherapy, which was very wrong. So the correct answer is EBUS guided biopsy. We did endobronchial ultrasound guided biopsy, TBNA taken for cytology, cell block, culture, AFB culture and gene expert, and cytology and cell block were negative for malignancy, but surprisingly gene expert was positive for tuberculosis, and it was rifampicin sensitive. So with the advent of this endobronchial ultrasound, patient is saved from chemotherapy and patient is put on EKT. Now endobronchial ultrasound is a technique that uses ultrasound along with bronchoscope to visualize airway wall and structures adjacent to it, be it tumor or lymph nodes. When you start endobronchial ultrasound, you should be well aware of mediastinal lymph node sessions. So all the pulmonologists usually they are aware of these are the different mediastinal stations, and there are 14 stations, and except 5, 6 and 8, 9 all can be biopsied with endobronchial ultrasound. There are mainly two types of EBUS, convex probe EBUS and radial probe EBUS. Here it is a very advanced technology. You must have seen that sonography probe. It is this much big. Now they have made it so small that it can be fixed on the bronchoscope. So they have fixed the sonography probe on the bronchoscope, and it is 7.5 megahertz convex transducer placed at the tip of flexible bronchoscope, and its outer diameter is slightly higher than routine bronchoscope. It is 6.9 mm. Now, convex probe EBUS is mainly used for diagnosis of mediastinal and central lesions. Radial probe is mainly used for the diagnosis of peripheral lung lesions. Here in this slide, you can see that this is a small lesion in the lung, which cannot be biopsied with either CT-guided biopsy because there is lung in between, or in bronchoscopy, it will not be visualized. Here you can see with radial probe, the mass is clearly visualize, and you can take biopsy from it. Advantages of EBUS, that it has got high diagnostic yield with to the extent of almost 90 to 98%, low complication rate, very low complication rate, less than 1%, and core obtained with tBNA can be used for immunohistochemistry and molecular testing. People think that needle aspirations, they will be, only cytology will be examined, but we send it for core, for immunohistochemistry and molecular testing also. So it can also be done. The indications of endobronchial ultrasound is diagnosis of any kind of mediastinal lymphadenopathy, be it malignant, tuberculous or lymphoma. Diagnosis of lung mass located near the airway wall but outside the airway wall. When we previously used to do bronchoscopy, around 50% of the lesions, they are central but they used to be outside the bronchoscope. So in those cases, we can utilize endobronchial ultrasound. Diagnosis of peripheral lung lesions, particularly radial probe EBUS. Once radial probe EBUS is there, you can biopsy any damn lesion in the lung, any how small it is there. Staging of lung cancer, for staging, it is the gold standard now. It has replaced mediastinoscopy. Diagnosis of sarcoidosis, diagnosis of lymphomas. And in our country, it is very important, it can be a very good tool for diagnosis of TB and other infective mediastinal lymphadenopathy. Contraindications, there are very few contraindications similar as routine bronchoscopy, like life-threatening cardiac arrhythmia, current or recent MI, poorly controlled heart failure, severe hypoxemia, and uncooperative patient. So basically, patient has to be stable. Relative contraindications are current antiplatelet agents, current anticoagulant therapy, coagulopathy, thrombocytopenia, and elevated blood urea and serum creatinine. Here we can do EBUS after correction of coagulopathy. Now, technique of EBUS, it is an OPD procedure. Patient does not require admission also. We do it under local and short sedation. Bronchoscope is passed through oral cavity. Routine bronchoscope is passed through nasal cavity. And after localizing the lymph node, special tBNA needle is inserted and tBNA is taken under real-time guidance. This needle is very costly. One needle costs around 21,000 rupees. Now, this is a small video which will show you.
Many times, there are mediastinal lymph nodes and lung mass which are outside the bronchus and cannot be biopsied by routine bronchoscopy. These can be biopsied by EBUS tBNA.
Here you can see that that needle is going inside the bronchoscope. It is a special needle and special adapter is there. Here that needle is coming out, lymph node is visualized under real-time guidance, and then we are taking the jabs. Here it is taken on slide, and then slides are prepared for cytology. And we get also core tissue like this. Sometimes coagulated material is also there. And this is another tissue fragments. This can be utilized for immunohistochemistry and molecular markers. We also do rapid on-site evaluation, that is like frozen section. We immediately at that point we get the result whether a patient is having malignancy or some infective etiology. So that further sampling is required or not, we decide whether we need to take more samples from the same lymph node or other lymph node, whether adequate material is there or not, and probable diagnosis so that further processing can be guided. So cost can be reduced, like if malignancy is there, there is no need to send for cultures. So cost can be reduced. Complications, it has got very low complications, usually very safe procedure. No serious complications were found in a systemic review of effectiveness and safety of EBUS. Rare complications are agitation, cough, hypoxia, laryngeal injury, fever, bacteremia. infection, bleeding, and pneumothorax. We usually see PT-APTT before doing EBUS. Role in lung cancer. It is a diagnosis of lung cancer. Staging of lung cancer, it is gold standard now. It has replaced mediastinoscopy. Restaging of mediastinum after chemotherapy. That means many a times in stage 3A disease, they give chemotherapy, they downstage the disease, and then they go for surgery. So after giving chemotherapy, they see that whether there are any lymph nodes who are positive or not. Depending on that, they decide whether surgery is possible or not. Evaluation of post-operative lymphadenopathy in lung cancer patients or any other cancer patient, like in this patient, CA esophagus. Now, for diagnosis and staging of lung cancer, it has got very good sensitivity and specificity. It has diagnostic yield around 96%. Here, in this study done by Yasufuku, diagnostic yield was 96% and 29 mediastinoscopy, 8 thoracoscopies, 4 VATs and 9 CT-guided biopsies were avoided. As compared to PET and CT, you can see that it has got sensitivity and specificity around above 90%, whereas PET has got around 55% and CT has got around 70%. Restaging of mediastinum, like we have seen in the summary, that it is a very diagnostic tool, and it has got a big role in pulmonary, particularly in diagnosis and staging of malignancy and infective etiology. And it has got very high diagnostic yield to the extent of around 90 to 98%. And it has got very low complication rate. Thank you.